And we're going to learn how to add and subtract polynomials.
So it's not going to be like percents, decimals, nothing like that?
Nope. So before we go into adding and subtracting polynomials, let's remember some things. So say I have an expression like 7y squared minus 6y plus 4. We've already done this. What are the terms of this expression? The terms are what's separated by the plus and minus signs. So the terms would be 7y squared, negative 6y, and 4. We have done this, right?
Yeah.
So these are the terms. Do you guys remember what coefficients are?
Yeah.
What are the coefficients of this expression?
The 6.
The 7, the negative 6, and the 4. Coefficients are the numbers in front of the variables. Could have somewhere we've done this. Chapter 3, maybe? Okay. So terms are what's separated by the plus and minus signs, yeah?
I think the coefficients is the number in front
of
the
variable. Yeah. 4 doesn't have a variable, so it's just 4. But it's a constant, that is the coefficient. Just that constant. Yes, 4 is the coefficient of 4. It has no variable, so it's just a number. Okay? And we always take the sign along with our answer. So we're looking for terms. If the term was negative, then the coefficient's going to be negative as well. Okay. Keeping that in mind, we remember what like terms are. I know for sure we went over these. So what are like terms? Huh? Terms that are alike, yeah. 7y and 6y would be like terms. 7y squared and 6y would not be like terms. So these are like terms, these are not like terms. For two numbers, two variables, two terms to be like terms, they have to have the same variable and the same power, remember that? So these two both have a variable y and a power of 1. These two have the same variable but different powers, so that's why they're not like terms. Okay, now that we know that, we're going to use the number of terms to define what we call the polynomials. So these are all polynomials, but we have specific names. If a polynomial has only one term, like for example, the polynomial 5x cubed, we're going to call that a monomial. Mono meaning one term. That looks really tiny, doesn't it?
Did you
have Didn't I have what last week?
No.
If a polynomial has only one term, then we call it a monomial. I just got the joke. That was a terrible joke, whoever said it. Okay. If we have an expression with two terms, for example, like 1/3 r minus 1/2, we can call that binomial. Let's keep the jokes to yourselves. By meaning two terms. So what do you think a polynomial with three terms is going to be called?
Trinomial.
Yes. So, for example, 5x cubed minus 6x squared plus 2x, that's three terms, so that's going to be a trinomial. Anything bigger than that, we're just going to call a generic polynomial. We're not going to give it any specific classification other than that. But these are all technically polynomials. And a polynomial, by definition, is a sum or difference, sum or difference of monomials. So we're clear on what a polynomial is and how we define all the different polynomials? Okay. So say I have these two polynomials and I want to add them. So now we're going to learn how to add polynomial. So adding polys. So let's try an example A. Well, we have 3y plus 7, and I want to add to that negative 9y minus 14. Here I have two polynomials that I want to add together. What kind of polynomial is this one?
Binomial.
It's a binomial. What about this one?
Binomial.
Also binomial. Okay. When we're adding polynomials, all we're going to do is combine like terms. So to add polys, I'm going to add over here. Then we're going to combine like terms. And that's all I'm going to do. So let me drop my parentheses and just combine like terms. So if I drop my parentheses, I get 3y plus 7 plus negative 9y minus 14. What are my like terms in this polynomial? 3y and negative 9y, and then 7 and negative 14. Now, how do I combine like terms?
7 more 4.
So with 3 and negative 9, I just add up the coefficients and keep the same variable, right? So 3 minus 9, what's that?
6.
Negative 6, and what's my variable?
Y.
And then what about these two?
Negative 7.
Yes, negative 7. And that's it. I added the two polynomials together. All I did was combine like terms.
So isn't that like what we did in like three sections ago?
Yes. It's exactly like we did three chapters ago. That's it. So adding polynomials is just like combining like terms, which we learned in chapter 3.
So what is polynomials?
Subtracting polynomials. I'll get there in a second.
Way to go.
So say we have another group of polynomials that I want to add together. So I want to add x squared minus 4x minus 3, and I want to add to that 5x squared minus 6x. What kind of polynomials are these?
Try.
All right. Okay, and if I want to add the two polynomials together, what do I do?
Combine like terms.
Combine like terms, drop parentheses, combine like terms. What are my like terms in the polynomials? Dx's. That's a plus. The x's, the x squareds, and the negative 3's by itself. So we're left with x squared plus 5x squared. What's that?
7x squared.
6x squared.
Does it matter what order you put
it in? No, convention is we always go from the highest degree down, all the way to the constant. Negative 4x and negative 6x, what does that give me? And finally, negative 3 has no pairing, so it's just going to be negative 3. That's it. Let's say we have negative z squared minus 4.2z plus 11, and I want to add to that 9z squared minus 1.9z plus 6.3. So these are what kind of polynomials?
Trinomials,
okay. And if I want to add them together, we know how to do that. We just combine like terms. Let me show you a way that the book does it that they think might help. So one of the ways that they do it is they do it vertically, just like we add numbers vertically. So they have the first one up top, and they write the second one underneath it. And they just make sure to line up their like terms. And if you do it like this, this is the same thing as adding numbers vertically. We just add straight down. So negative z squared plus 9z squared. That's 8z squared. How do I add these two? How do I add two negative numbers?
Just add them.
Yes. So when I do that, I get negative 6.1z. And finally, these two, I get 17.3. guys having a nice conversation?
Sorry.
So then we're left with this part right here, and that's it. So we're clear on how to add polynomials, we're just combining like terms. Let's talk about subtracting polynomials. So subtracting polynomials. So let's start with an example. Let's say we have the binomial 9b minus 8. And I want to subtract from that the binomial 11b minus 20. I cannot just draw parentheses and combine like terms here. And here's why. The fact that there's a minus sign in between these two parentheses means that I want to subtract every single term inside of here from every single term in here. If you think of it vertically, 9b minus 8 minus 11b minus 20, I will be subtracting these two and subtracting these two, right? Okay, but in order for me to be able to subtract these two terms, essentially what I have to do is I have to take 9 minus 11 and negative 8 plus 20, because it was minus, but there's another minus in there. So to subtract the negative number is the same thing as to add that number. So to bypass this whole confusion, all we do is we just distribute the negative sign to every term inside the second polynomial. So the problem now becomes, the first one stays the same, 9b minus 8, and the second one becomes negative 11b, because we distributed that minus sign, plus 20, because we distributed that minus sign. Now we combine like terms. So my b's and my constants. And I just explained why there. And then I get 9 minus 11. What's 9 minus 11? Negative 2b, yep. And then negative 8 plus 20, what's that? And that's it. What's plus? Where would I add what?
9 plus 20.
Let's try one more. So let's try, let's say we have the polynomials 11x squared, 7x, and 2, and I want to subtract from that 15x squared plus 4x. So what am I going to do here?
Distribute
the negative. So when I do that, the first one stays the same. And the second one becomes and then combine like terms. So 11x squared and negative 15x squared, what's that? Negative 4x squared. 7x and negative 4x. Did I confuse you something? We're good?
3x.
Yep. Sorry guys, 1 second, I was talking. And then the last, the 2, can I combine that with anything?
No.
So I'm left with 2. And that's it. Let me give you one and then you can do it and tell me what the answer is. And you can do this vertically as well. We just talked about how to do it vertically. Essentially, you make sure you subtract every second polynomial from the first one. So let's try negative 3y squared plus 5y minus negative 7y squared plus y minus 4. All right, so try that one. Tell me what you get.
Wait, I have a question.
Yes.
If there are any negatives, is that going to change?
Yeah. The effect of distributing that negative sign is that it changes all the signs inside.
Okay.
So all these are going to change.
So what's on the inside right now? It's positive.
If it's negative, it's going to become positive. If it's positive, it's going to become negative. So this becomes positive, negative, positive.
Yes. Yeah.
Excuse.
What is?
Yeah. 4y squared plus 4y plus 4?
Yeah. It's not a negative 7. It's a positive 7 when you distribute. You guys finished back there?
No.
What did you get?
No.
Good job, Tiffany. She told me. Alright, so when I distribute that negative sign, the first one stays the same. What does the second polynomial become?
Positive. 7y.
What can I combine?
Y.
Squared. With 5y.
With y.
Okay, so when I combine negative 3y squared and 7y squared, what do I get?
4y squared.
Y is it what? When I combine the y's, what do I get?
4.
And finally, the 4 is left by itself. So that's it. Okay, so we're clear on how to add polynomials. To add polynomials, we just combine like terms. To subtract polynomials, let me just write it up here. We distribute the negative. Distribute the minus sign. Okay, let's talk about evaluating polynomials, which again, we've done before, so that's not new to this section. So evaluating polys. So way back when in chapter 3, we had something like evaluate 2y cubed plus y squared minus 6 when y equals negative 3. What did we do when we wanted to evaluate something before? Plug in the y and see what it gives you, right? So everywhere there's a y, I'm going to plug in a negative 3. And then use the order of operations to simplify. By the way, if you want to make sure your signs are in order, always put parentheses around where the variable used to be. Okay, so what am I going to do first? I don't have any parentheses that I can do anything inside, right? Because all the insides are already simplified. So I'm going to jump to exponents. So I have exponents here and here. So negative 3 cubed, what's that? And don't say negative 9. Negative 27. How do I know it's negative?
If the sign is negative,
it's 3. I was going to say because 3 is an odd number.
Yeah, 3 is an odd number. So what happens is I'm going to have negative 3 times negative 3 times negative 3, 3 times. Two of them are going to get paired to be a positive, and one of them is going to be left. So that's why odd powers give you a negative number. Okay? Is this one going to be positive or negative?
Positive.
Positive 9, because there's two negative 3s that are going to be paired to give me a positive 9. Now what do I do? Yes. What do I get? Negative 54. And then what order do I do the last bit in? Go from left to right, right? So when I add negative 54 and 9, what do I get?
45.
Negative 45. And when I subtract these two, what do I get? So we're clear on all this, how I went from all the way to the top to all the way to the bottom? Okay.